Good morning. It's time to get up, up, up. It's time to get up. Come on, Anna. Time to up and at 'em. Time to. Hannah, the early bird gets the worm.
I'm not a bird. I don't care.
Well,
it's still nighttime outside, okay? You're waking us up at nighttime. It's not fair.
Hannah, you didn't let me finish. If you get up now, you'll be able to tell the teachers how you feel about getting up in the morning.
Oh, God, they're not in my house, are they?
Oh, no, silly. In a video.
Oh, the phone. Gimme, gimme.
Wow, look how fast you got up. And you're always telling me about how hard it is.
The perfect motivation, Mommy. Okay, now, you might notice how groggy I am, how tired I am, how pissed off I am. I'm gonna do a leading question, even though you probably know what the answer is. Do you know the worst part of the day, in my opinion? The worst part, the one that makes me dread school the most, that makes me yearn for the weekends, that puts me in the worst mood? Getting up at 7 a.m. every morning. It is too early. Our teachers are just cruel to be doing that to us. You know what? I've learned something about our brains. See, adults, they probably think that we simply just want to stay up late and sleep in, like it's just in our teenage interests. But apparently, the teenage brain works out so that we don't feel tired until like 11 or even 12, and we don't like feel non-tired until 9 or 10. So you see, our brains are actually wired, like, our brains release some kind of waking chemical, like, I don't even remember what it's called, but it's not released until, like, 9 or 10 in the morning. That's why it's so frigging hard to get up at 7 or 8. It's like, so really, our brains are wired to get up earlier. We're messing with the chemistry of our brains by waking up at 7 under the influence of adults. And they have the ability to go to bed at like 8 and get up at 7. That's why it's easier for them. That's why the adults are always like, oh, up and at 'em, early bird gets the worm. And the teachers are like, sorry, the students are like, no. And you know what, teachers? You want us to get good grades, don't you? Well, this actually gets us bad grades. We come to school all tired because we got up at 7 a.m. We don't do well in school. We don't listen because all we want to do is go back home and sleep until 9 or 10, get our 2 extra hours of sleep. And, okay, we'd be getting better grades. Studies actually show we'd be getting better grades if you let us get up at 9 or 10 instead of freaking 7. This is even worse in October or November, because remember what I said about being dark out? Well, it's still dark at 7 in the morning. I wake up, my alarm buzzes. No, it's still dark outside. I have to get up at night. Not cool, okay? I don't like it. I'm cold because my fan is on. I'm tired because of my teenage brain. It's dark outside. It looks like nighttime. I don't want to get up. You're all lucky that I even try, okay? And I come to school. I'm all tired. I can't listen. I'm so tired. It's not fair that teachers do this to us. Teachers, stop getting us up early. We are not early birds. They say the early bird gets the worm. Guess what? We're not birds. We're teenagers. We need to get up early. We need to get up late. I'm sorry. The reason I made that mistake is because I had to get up at 7 this morning and I'm still tired. So my brain is all messed up because I had to get up. I was messing with the chemistry of my brain. All these adults expect me to hop out of bed like the prancy little bunny that I'm not. Thank you and good night. Or good morning, whatever.